Hello, in today's artist review, I would like to tell you about one of my favorite artists and who really influenced me, not necessarily in my photography, but influenced me as an artist and how I see art and how I see world. Her name is Renneke Dijkstra, and she is a Dutch photographer born in Netherlands in 1953. And she is famous for the ability to show the specialness of the ordinary, because she photographs, or rather documents, people and people's life in the form of portraits. Portraits on location mostly. And the first series I would like to show you is her beach portraits that she started working on in 1992, and that's what made her really worldwide famous. Her work is now exhibited and has been exhibited all around the world in many galleries and exhibitions, museums. And specifically, she's been showing at San Francisco MoMA Museum, New York Guggenheim, International Center of Photography in New York. She also received the Hasselblad Award, Kodak Award, honorary fellowship of the Royal Photographic Society. So, I mean, she's a very established photographer with a very specific voice and viewpoint. And when she photographs, what she says about her subjects, she says, "I'm always looking for authenticity in people, their individuality and how they distinguish themselves from each other, but also what connects them and how people relate to each other." And you can see this in the series of beach portraits. So the subjects are centered in the frame. There's very similar lighting between them. And these are all teenagers. And what she, I guess, noticed while photographing teenagers, that they are more themselves. They're not yet so conscious about how they look. At the same time, they're quite awkward in front of the camera. And so I think that awkwardness is what makes them, that relates them, and that what makes this whole project so accomplished. Because you can really see, and no matter where these teenagers are, because she photographed it across the world on different beaches in Europe, in Ukraine, in America, but you can see that there are certain similarities between the awkwardness, between how they pose their body. For example, in this image, she looks like this Botticelli's Venus. And they are not so self-aware, and they may be not so much in control of their body language, and therefore that makes them more real and more relatable, because we've all been teenagers, we've all felt so awkward with our own bodies and with our own how we perceive ourselves. And so that's why this project was so successful and so moving to many people and received so much attention. And then she photographed another series also in the early 90s. She got an access to a hospital and photographed women who just gave birth, like literally, I think, within a couple of hours that they gave birth, she photographed them with their newborn babies. And these pictures, they tell us so much. They tell us so much. And when she, again, talks about her work, she says that in that concentrated and clenched moment of a picture, in the small details you can perceive in it, you can generate attention and meaning, which mostly escape us in everyday life. And I think when you really, when you really see this moment of someone just being born and a new mother, and you know, how they must feel, and you see all these little details in them, in their body, in their changes of their body. You can see, you know, all these little things that we don't really see in the popular culture, right? We all are used to seeing, you know, motherhood as something really, really beautiful, and it's of course a happy event in our lives, but we're not so exposed to the other side of it, to maybe some really uncomfortable elements that people choose not to look at and not to see. And now you're facing this portrait and you are sort of forced to notice the details of that moment in life. So I think, to me, this is definitely a very profound series that had a very big influence on me. And another series that I wanted to talk about is her series when she documented the growth of this girl. Her name is Almarisa. She immigrated with her parents, or maybe just her mom, I don't know, from Bosnia to Netherlands. And first, Renike found her at this center for immigrants, where she had to stay for a month or so. And basically like a refugee center. And so she stayed there with other parents and kids. And so Renike came there to photograph children, and then somehow this girl caught her attention, and so she photographed her sitting in this red chair, all dressed up very nicely. And then she decided to follow up with this girl in a year or so, and sort of made a connection with her family, and she started visiting her in her house and document different stages of life of this girl. So when she photographed her, it was obviously a special moment for the girl. She was being photographed. So I watched an interview with the girl where she was saying that she always tried to wear her best dress and look the nicest she could. And you can see this, you know, this excitement, but at the same time, you can also see that she's very at ease with the photographer. And I think they had a long conversation between each other before Renike stopped her and said, okay, now I'm going to take a picture. Took a picture and then continued talking to the girl. And I thought it was so nice that the photographer was able to establish this connection and trust with the subject. Of course, it has something to do with the fact that she's still a little girl and she has less of that self-awareness and less of that guard. But it's also interesting that Renike says whether someone will surrender to the camera and drop their pose a bit, you never know. And it's something that you only discover as you start photographing, especially when you're photographing someone, you know, a stranger, that someone you haven't really been in, you know, in a long conversation with. And what she says that everything should come together like a puzzle pieces, the posture, gestures, the facial expression, but also the composition and the light, and the colors, and then certain details, especially ones that you don't notice at first, that can lift the picture above itself. And so in these pictures, you can really start noticing the details. Like, for example, in this shot, this little girl, she had this manicure that you can't really see in this resolution, but she really does have nails painted like ladybug, for example. And so these are the details that really lift the picture and make it so interesting. So the next, when she's already a teenager, so these pictures were shot approximately 2 years apart at her home. And you can also see that every time she's sitting in the chair, and also the artist talks about the evolution of that chair, that it becomes more and more solid, grounded, big and comfortable as opposed to that first plastic chair that she was in the refugee center on. And now you can see that getting in her more mature years. And the last picture of the series is when Almerisa already has her own baby. And I think it's so fascinating to photograph someone's life over so many years. So this series was done from 1994 to 2005. And when the artist talks about photographing, working on a series over so many years, she thinks and she believes that the family will continue to evolve, the differences will be barely visible from day to day. So it's the unchanging portrait that will make them conscious of all the changes. So when this little girl, or when this grown-up woman looks back at herself as a little girl, that's when she can really notice those changes. And what she says also, that that will make the portrait a kind of a baseline, a lasting reminder that the time goes by. And I think this is so true and so wise, to have this observation of our lives, that we can only, the only evidence that we can have now about the time going by is those pictures that we took at a certain point of our lives, or someone photographed us. So, you know, when you look at her series, you can notice all this intention of an artist to capture that moment, to capture someone at the very special moment, very specific moment of their life when they were a teenager or a child, maybe a certain fragility or certain, you know, the feeling of not being comfortable with yourself or with the world. And so this other series that I wanted to show you, which is also, I really can look at Renike's work for forever, because every series is so wise and so fascinating and so beautiful. So in this series, she photographed teenagers in parks. It's called Park Portraits, and she was working on it in 2005, 2006, and maybe even later, but this is the first, sort of the first stage of the series. And again, photographing these teenagers and their, at the same time, awkwardness but also openness to the camera, and using just a little bit of light, artificial light, makes this, together in combination with the poses and everything, makes this portrait really look like some, I don't know, Renaissance or some sort of paintings that are, you know, they definitely reference into those other older painting periods, art periods, that we all have sort of this cultural heritage in the back of our mind. And then so when we look at these portraits, we can really see the reminiscence of all those paintings. And so this is, I think, to me, that's so beautiful and so special. And especially when you're able to see the character, the youth, how honestly they are looking at the camera, and how they are, you know, as themselves, just having that moment in their life. I think it's such a special connection with them too. Maybe some of them are more comfortable, some of them are less comfortable, but you can really see that special moment between the subject and the photographer. And the moment that will also be important for them to go back to when they look back at these pictures, just like Renike says. And I hope you can also relate and find the same things that I'm able to find when I look at these pictures. And I really encourage you to explore more of her work and follow up and, you know, see her other series. And I hope this whole review was inspiring and interesting to learn about. And please, if you want to see more of my reviews, as always, like and subscribe. You will see all the links down below in the description. And thank you for watching.